Okay, I'm back with a part two. I just couldn't let it go quite yet. So basically, most of what the order is about getting you ready to fight those beings, creating a sense of power within yourself, creating a sense of, yes, I can, and I can stand against anything. And that's not always going to be that easy, but the more you can believe it, the more you see yourself in your mind's eye being that type of person, the more you will become it, because the astral world contains all possibility, and it's sort of like a rough draft of reality. It hasn't hit the final edit yet, so you can change things. If you don't like your life right now, think of your story, think of your life as a story. If you don't like what has been written about you so far, change the fucking story. I don't care who says, oh, that's bullshit, it can't work, blah, blah, blah. Let those people believe that. Because here you go. If you're in a room and there's two men and there's a stone in the middle of the room, and one man believes that he has the potential to lift it, and the other man believes he doesn't have the potential, guess what? Both are right. And if you believe you have the potential to lift it, guess what? You will. You can. Maybe not yet, but one day you will. And that day when you do it, it will be worth everything that you went through to get there. So if you don't like your life right now, change the story. Will people notice it? Yes. Will there be people who doubt you and try to pull you back into the reality that they know? Yes. But guess what? Sometimes you have to say, fuck them. And that's one of the traps that Christianity uses. You're like, oh, well, you're becoming a better person. You're not humble. You're not this, you know, blah, blah, blah. And you know what? They want you in a state of fear and in a state of weakness, because that makes you dependent on them. You know, I don't need Jesus. I don't care if, you know, about, you know, him in a way that he's my savior. I don't need him. I don't want him at that, but I can look at the story of Jesus and say, what an amazing inspiration. I can be that now. I can be the sun, the little miniature sun that I can be, and I'm going to shine my light. And everyone else around me is either going to hate that light or want to come near it. And then because they're near it, they're like, you know what? I got it within me too. And they're going to shine it. And then you have a bunch of other little lights shining. And then other little lights are going to shine. And all these other little sparks of lights are going to go all around. And all these non-believers are just going to sit there with their thumbs at their ass going, well, why is everyone shining their light and not me? Well, you know what? Fine. If they want to get on board, let them. If not, don't let them. You know, whatever. It doesn't matter. They don't need to be with you, as long as you're doing what you know you need to do. And all those little lights begin to coalesce and come together. And suddenly, it's a giant sun. A giant, beautiful sun that dispels the darkness and sends all those crusty fucking race and reptiles and Illuminati scumbags running. It's going to be like when a ship hits the rocks and all those rats run and jump ship. That's what it's going to look like. All these screaming little rat fucks are going to come running around. And all they are is a bunch of sissy Nancys that love to molest kids, that love to humiliate others, because all they are is a bunch of spineless, yellow-bellied little sissy nannies whose only power comes from deception, lies, and fear. And as strong as that power feels, it's the most easily vanquished of all. The reptilian agenda, that's another issue. Those guys are a little bit stronger. But guess what? If eons and eons ago, a bunch of individuals got together and said, fuck you to the reptilian agenda, and scared them and chased them so bad that they had to run and leave the physical dimension and enter into the astral dimension to hide, guess what? History will repeat. Let me say that again. History will repeat. These crusty, scaly, snaky bastards. You've got no power here anymore, and people are waking up to you, and people are seeing themselves as the great dragon slayers of the past who kicked the shit out of you, who went down with iron swords and shields, with the love of great entities in their hearts, and they came down into your slippery, shit-filled tunnels, and they took the big blade and they just stuck it right into you like a she-bitch coyote. And they bled you out like a stuck pig. Guess what, motherfuckers? That's what's gonna happen, because there's a lot of people here going, I'm gonna wake up, I'm gonna see myself as St. George, I'm gonna see myself as a dragon slayer, and guess what? A dragon slayer slays dragons. And the more we become dragon slayers, the more dragons we gotta slay to keep up with it. That's what we're doing. In the astral world, that's what becomes possible. Believing in yourself, seeing it happen, and watching it manifest around you. That is the great inspiration. And the more people that gather around you, the more people that notice the change in you, just let them naturally become it. If you want to share this information with them, share it. If not, you know, when they're ready, they'll find it. We do a lot of ritual work here within the order to make sure that people find what they need to find when they're ready to find it. We don't evangelize. I'm just putting this out here for people to begin to make real within themselves. We're no leaders, we're no gurus, we're not spiritual masters. We're just people who are just fed the fuck up with this evil, cowardice, sickness, sissy Nancy, panty bullshit that these people do. They've lied, they've put this veil in front of people, and they've turned otherwise good people against each other. They've made people suffer. So what? So they can sleep on silk sheets and they can have, you know, nice little cushions on their toilets because they can't control their bowels anymore and they have to sit there for 6 fucking hours just to pass, which, you know, what's something that a normal human being wakes up in the morning, does, and gets on with their lives. This is the kind of thinking you've got to begin to apply to these people. They're weak. They're sick. Have you ever seen David Rockefeller? He's a decrepit lich. He looks like that little fucking thing that hangs out on Jabba the Hutt. And that is what all his Illuminati magic and all the reptilian power has gotten him. Yeah, does he got a lot of money? But he's got to pay women billions of dollars just to touch him. And believe me, looking at the guy, I know it's not women he's paying to touch him. I mean, this is how sick these people are. And I'm not bashing on homosexuals. We've got 2 members who are homosexuals who are the most badass guys I've ever met, and they will take on anyone for what's right. And so I'm not bashing on homosexuals. I'm bashing on the sick, little, disgusting homo perverts who target children who are all members of the Illuminati, because that's what they do. They have these guys have sex with kids, and they've got power to blackmail, and they use that fear and that humiliation for their dark, disgusting ritual. And the reptilians sit back and they laugh. They love it, because now they can get us to harm our own kids. Guess what? They own those crusty old men so hard that I don't even know how to explain it. So, getting back to the astral world, because I can rant, trust me. Begin to see yourself as a mighty champion, as a humble champion, as someone that other people want to meet, someone other people need, someone of value and of worth, not an elitist asshole. You need to begin to see yourself as valuable and worth a lot to humanity. Like, you have a lot to offer, so offer it. So be it. Use the astral world. Use your imagination, you know, to create the world that you want. It doesn't matter that you're not, you know, flying down the tunnel and whatnot and seeing the silver cord and all that, you know. Yeah, it's kind of true, but in the most part, it's bullshit. It doesn't matter. As long as you revisit it and revisit it and revisit that image over and over and over again, every single day, you will eventually become it. You become the story that you tell yourself. I told myself that I was a strong, powerful, useful human being, that people will go, whoa, there's a son of Thor. And 6 years later, people go, dude, have you ever heard of Thor? Because you're that strong. And I say, you know what? I have. And this isn't me being elitist. This is me just saying, look what's possible. So look in your heart. See what's possible. If you love Thor, do the same thing. If you love George the Dragon Slayer, be George the Dragon Slayer. Be the change. Envision it. Imagine it. That's the astral world right there, is your imagination. They're deeper levels, absolutely. But that's the opening door. See yourself as the great being that you want to be. Use those heroes as inspiration. Use them until you go, you know what? Thank you very much. Please begin to guide me, but I need to become my own man or my own woman. And guess what? It'll happen. I'm with you. The order is with you. Thank you so much for being with us. That's the astral world. Get working.